What's up guys, welcome back to another video. In this one I'm showing you how I'm taking this opening here and I'm making some French doors to make it look like this. I'm gonna walk you through all those steps in this video, how I did it from start to finish, starting with the layout, the prep work, and then we're gonna take it outside so I can show you how I'm prepping all the material and getting it ready for this new French door. So let's get to that, let's go. Okay guys, so check this out. So pardon the mess around me, I've been doing a lot of projects recently and I just haven't had time to clean up. So I'm gonna show you some of the materials I'll be using to build this French door. For starters, lumber. You're gonna need some lumber. So what I have here is four pieces of softwood or southern yellow pine wood. I have four 2x4x8s, and then I also have a 2x6x8. And then additionally to that, I have 1x4s by 6 feet long. And so I'm gonna be using these to infill the doors in the middle and give it a good, a nice custom look there for like a nice design. But that's the lumber portion. To get the door installed, I'll be using some hinges. I got these hinges matte black for the doors. I have three on each side, so six total. I have some handles to pull the door open, and then I also have these adjustable ball catches for the top of the doors for whenever they snap into place. So something else you'll need for that. And then to finish the door off, I have three different stains, and I'm going to show you at the end of this video how all these three different stains are going to look as far as the application goes. But I'm going to be trying this and see if it works out for me. If it doesn't, too bad, I'll have to live with it. But I'm going to be showing you guys what it looks like using three different stains. So the first stain that I'm going to use is a white Walsh pickling stain, and then after this I'm going to go ahead and go over it with a golden oak stain, and then two coats of this, let it dry, and then the final cut will be with a weathered oak on top of it. So I'm gonna show you guys how that goes. If it doesn't go well, sorry, at least I tried. That's why I'm making this video, to help you guys make a determination if it makes sense for you. So that's the material side of things. Now what I'm gonna start doing is prepping the lumber. That's this portion here, prep work is done. Now let's go ahead and move forward on the cutting. Let's go. First, okay guys, so now that the planing and the sanding is done, what I'm gonna do now is start prepping the door for dimensions. So the first thing I'm gonna do is measure the top, the middle, and the bottom. Out of those three dimensions, I'm gonna go with the smallest one because I need to make sure that this door is plumb and squared whenever I do install it. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so I got all my dimensions, 31 1/8, 31 1/4, and 31 1/4. So out of those three, the smallest one is 31 1/8. So what I'm gonna do is go outside and start my rough opening dimension for the actual frame. I already bought the frame for this area, so what I'm gonna do is start assembling it, and then from there, I'll start working my way in to figure out my dimensions from edge to edge, and then also from floor to the top of the jamb. So let's go also measure that. So 31 1/8 by 80 inches. So 80 inches, the door will most likely be about 79 inches or so. 31 by 80 are my dimensions. Let's go. Okay guys, I didn't go over this piece earlier, but this is my jamb set for the door. You can buy these at your local big box store. Essentially what it is, it's as if you were buying a door, but without the door. It's just a frame, right? So it's the jamb set. Now what I'm gonna do is start cutting this to size. Now you'll notice that it doesn't come with door stops, but I bought some extra pieces to help me with the door stops, and I'll show you what that looks like whenever we do install it. See, it has a lip there for the top piece to go, so you don't want to cut that end. Now sometimes you want to probably use a level laser just to make sure that your floor is leveled, because sometimes what tends to happen is, although both dimensions are the same, it could be that your dimensions are the same but they're crooked, and so you want to make sure that even though you know, they are the same, that it's level, because if not, there'll be some big inconsistencies and headaches whenever you do hang your door. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm cutting these pieces now. 79 3/8 was the height. Okay guys, so what I'm doing now is I'm getting ready to cut my styles with the dado blade. Now DeWalt doesn't recommend you install a dado blade with this table saw, but I've done it before. It's just something you're gonna have to determine if it's safe for you to do or not. And so I've done it, so I'm gonna keep doing it, and then I'm proceeding at risk, but this is not recommended by DeWalt. So use caution when you are doing this. So now that the dado blade's installed, I have the other one removed. Here's the one that comes with the actual table saw. I'm gonna start taking these pieces through it, go ahead and get that flawless cut down the middle, and then start prepping it to put it all together. So let's go. All right guys, so I got the blade set to where I want it to be. What I did is I ran a mock-up through the blade first to make sure that my dado cut was exact to a 3/4 inch piece of plywood. And so now it fits perfect. I had done it too big on this side, so now it's fixed. So that's what you want, right? So now that I got that part done, I'm gonna go ahead and start running my long piece through it. Alright gang, so check it out. Now that I have these pieces cut, what I did with the first one was I got all the pieces and I infilled them in. Let's get all these pieces in. Install all these and see how they fit. Just go over with this and then put it on the edge here so that I can draw the line. So now I'm gonna go ahead and cut all those and then we'll start putting it together. All right, so now I'm cutting all the pieces so that they can fit inside. I'm gonna give these a good sand before, because I like, when you buy 1x4s, they have squared edges. And so I'm gonna go ahead and smoothen out these edges, just give it a sand. That way it has a nice little bevel. And so it'll just make it a nice clean look when they abut to each other, and you'll see what they look like whenever you see the finished ones. But in any case, I'm gonna go ahead and sand these and then take them over there and start installing them. All right guys, I'm back in action. So like I was saying, now I'm just gluing them. And so what I like to do is just put glue on the ends only. Don't put glue here or here, because you can if you want, but you know, just use caution, because it's gonna show whenever you're applying it on the other areas. Alright, just this one. And then, just on the inside. And then, once you get it in place, you can look here, take these nails. Just get hold of the inside. 1 foot. 1 inch. Get it from there. The reason I'm nailing it up here as well is because it helps it whenever you're installing the top. You know, it's a good guiding point, and it also just bonds the door a lot better. I think, come on, come. Work for me. Now let's get some glue on this bad boy. Then on this one. Alright, so that's how I got them all in. And now what I'm going to do is now install the top piece. And so all I did was put some glue on top of this like this. And then just bring this bad boy on top. You want to get the tight side in first, and I think this is the tight side. Just like that. And then you realize that there you go. Look at that. Now I'm just gonna give some courtesy nail shots here at the bottom. There you go. Now you can obviously, I'm still going to sand the rails and styles, but for the most part, that's pretty much it, how I assembled it. And then I'll give it a sand, stain it, a couple coats, and then I'll get ready to go install it inside. But that's pretty much the process there on assembling the door after you've cut all the dado cuts and whatnot. So that's it on this. Okay, guys, so I got the doors prepped and sanded now. It's about 5 o'clock today, so I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this work session. I'm gonna come back tomorrow and we'll continue this build. We'll see you tomorrow. Okay guys, so now that I have the doors, this is from day two of this build. So now that we have started working on, now that we already let these dry, what I'm gonna work on now is putting them in position to prep for the hinges and the other areas. Now, I'm gonna stain them some other time. I thought about it a little bit more and I figured let me just get them installed first. So this is kind of the way I'm gonna position the doors. What I'm gonna start working on now is cutting out the locations for the hinges. in the position. Make sure it's leveled. All right, so that's it. Lining in. Get with it. Now. That's chance two. Hold up. That's a chance. I'm going to use that because if not, you're screwed. Okay. I just need.
Okay, guys, so I got the jam now installed. And so what I'm doing is I'm hammering in some brad nails just to start off. And then once I get the door installed, I'll have to adjust a little bit because sometimes, you know, the wood tends to warp a little bit. And I don't have one of those planers that can get it all evened out. So I'm gonna try and figure out how to get it positioned to where it's flush in the middle. And so let's go get these doored now and then start seeing how it starts falling into place. So let's do that.
Door number two. All right, so this is the area where the door was sticking out a little bit at the bottom again. I don't have a joiner, so I'll have to improvise a little bit and get it somewhat flush. So what I'm doing is I'm just gonna take my handheld planer and I'm gonna go over it a couple of times. Now I can see my line right there and I have a little bit to go because I've already done a couple passes, so I wanted to test it out, see how it would work. So I'm gonna just keep doing it till I get it to a point where it's somewhat meeting that line down here. And so I'm pretty close in most spots. I think I'm good up here. I just got a little bit to go down here. So I'm gonna continue hitting this area as this is a spot that kind of warped a little bit more. So I'm just gonna get my planer and just go over it a couple times. Okay. Let me show you what it looks like up close. So there's the line right there, and it was a quarter of an inch earlier, but I've planed it down. You can see the line over here is kind of right on it, but you can see that end is a little bit thicker than this end over here because I've planed it down a little bit, but look at that dip right there. But in any case, no one's really going to notice this. Again, this is a quick, easy way of doing it with a handheld planer. Whenever I do install it, you won't even tell the difference on this, but okay, so now that it's been sanded and it's ready to be stained, first thing I did is I used a wood stain. It's fast drying, water-based product. So again, the first one I went over with was the White Walsh pickling wood stain, just to kind of give it a good contrast between both stains. And so that's the next one I'm working on now. Get this one going. Door number two is drying over there. As soon as I get this one going, that's next. We'll let these dry overnight because you don't want that smell inside the house, and then we'll put them up tomorrow and then see what the finished product looks like. So let's keep going. Hey, look. You can see here though. All right, guys, so check this out. So this is a golden oak color. So first I went over it with a White Walsh stain, let that dry for about an hour, and then I went over it with this golden oak stain, and then I'm going over it now with a weathered oak stain. And so this is the last stain that I'm gonna apply on it just to give it that final look. So we'll see what it all looks like when it's done, and then I'll give you guys my honest feedback on this. So let's keep it going. Okay, so here's what they look like after the third coat of the weathered oak. Okay, so you can see the doors are now hung. The stain has dried out completely to where they could be installed, and now they look great. So let's do a little recap of the kinds of stains that I used on these doors. So the first coat of stain that I applied on the door is a White Walsh pickling stain.
Now you can get this at the local big box store, any of these things you can. And so that was almost like a whitish color to give it that bleed through of white through some of the grains of the wood. This dried within an hour or so, for 30 minutes to an hour. After this was applied, I came back and I did a darker stain, which is the golden oak color. Now this stain, if you do multiple stains, it'll be very dark, but I only ended up doing one stain. After I applied it, I used a rag and wiped it all off and ended up looking great after that. This took about another hour or two to fully dry out, and then once this was done with the golden oak, I came back and topped it off with a weathered oak. Now this just allows some of the grain to bleed through a little bit more, and it also helps it create a mix of those two stains, and it ended up looking like this. You could probably get the same finish with the golden oak and not this one, but I wanted to try this on top of it to see what it would do. But this is the kind of look it gave me, and it looks great. So I used these three stains, and then after it was fully dried out, I came back with a polyurethane clear protection. Obviously it's a restroom, it's gonna get wet and steamy in here, and so I wanted to make sure that these doors are protected, and so I went over it with two coats of this. Now that these doors are hung, I'm very happy with the way they look, and hopefully you guys can use some of these stains and are able to stain your doors, and then it'll look somewhat like this. So again, clear and good finish on it, and I'm happy with the way they look for a DIY door. One more thing I forgot to note, the hardware. I ended up going with matte black finish on all my hardware. The door pulls, the ball latches, and the hinges. One thing you do have to keep in mind is if you do buy these pulls in the local stores, the screws are not long enough since they're made for 3/4 inch cabinets. And so since these doors are 2x4s or now really 1 3/8 inch, you have to get longer screws to go ahead and get them through these pulls. And then also be cautious when you drill the holes. You want to make sure you use a template. You can also buy a template at the store and use that for whenever you are drilling the holes for these pulls. But now that the hardware's installed, I'm very happy with the way it looks. And now I'm gonna go ahead and move and start installing the door stops. So let's do that. Now this is gonna be pretty straightforward. All I'm gonna use is a 1/4 inch by 1 inch piece. Cut it to size, install it on the inside of the frame. That way the door does not swing inward any more than it needs to. So first thing I'm gonna do is measure the inside piece. That's gonna be 28 inches. Okay guys, so my pieces are now cut. Again, all I'm using is just some, they're about 3/8 of an inch by about 1 3/8 inch, and so the ones that come on your doors are roughly the same size and thickness. So these are the little pieces they sell at the store. You can get these and use as a doorstop. Again, that's just going to be in the middle of the door to prevent that end swing. So let's install these bad boys. Okay guys, so unfortunately, sucks, but my DeWalt gun failed on me, and I think a part inside the gun is broken. And so I have to take it to a DeWalt factory service center to get it fixed. And so I have to do this the old school way and hammer in these pieces with a hammer, which sucks. It's all good. They did it back in the day, we can do it too. So let's go ahead and do this. Okay, so check it out. So now the door is officially installed with the door stops. Now you can see I just put in some small finishing nails for now, since my gun kind of gave up on me and I gotta go get that repaired. But for the most part, it works to where it does not cause the door to get pushed in anymore. So that's the purpose of those door stops. It works great. Happy with it now. I just have to go ahead and just paint the trim and the frame around it a white finished. And this is now good to go. Okay guys, that's it for this video. Hopefully you guys found something helpful out of this and are able to implement some of the tips and tricks I use to build this French door for your next project. I'm Jay with Jay Builds, and we'll catch you guys again on the next one. We'll see ya.